Have you had time to check on that poster yet? I keep wondering if it's come in. Sorry, I just get so excited, and I always feel like I miss everything that happens in town while I'm up here.
Poor Braxton.
I don't want to think about it.
Eaten by cannibals? What a way to go.
I put up with the constant stink of fish because I don't want to think about what's outside those walls.
I know. Just imagine if they fell. It'd be Amber Heights all over again.
That's it. You owe me your month's ration of Dabilarol.
It's nice to take a breather, ain't it?
Nice to see Nioka on the mend. What's that smell coming out of Celia's apartment?
Probably whatever she bought from that guy who sells animal parts.
Sebastian?
I swear, she buys something from him every day.
Hmm?
As you were.
Everything's spinning. I'm just gonna take it easy, okay? Everything's spinning. I'm just gonna take it easy, okay? Everything's spinning. I'm just gonna take it easy, okay?
Carry on.
Hmm?
everything's spinning. I'm just gonna take it easy, okay? You're the new face. Wow, you must be up on all the latest tossball games. So who do you follow? Wait, don't tell me. You look like a Hammersmith Thunder fan. No, Glacial Age Mammoths. Everyone needs a good diversion. That's what keeps you from thinking about the marauders outside town. The Raptodons chewing at the walls. Tossball's just about the only good news we get around here. When our frequency's not too clogged up anyway. So, what can I do for you? Graham's always filling the airwaves with this propaganda, like it's done him any good. All it means is the tossball games get to us in fragments. Makes them real hard to watch. Poor Isaac. I was wondering why I hadn't seen him in a few days. I'd really like to help. Isaac was a sweet fellow, even if he did have terrible teeth. Right. So the thing with Isaac is he didn't know where to stop. He'd get stuck on something, and he just couldn't let it go. Sometimes he'd drink purpleberry punch by the liter. Other times he'd keep betting on a losing team. Started owing the wrong people money. I don't know for sure, but I saw Elijah and his buddies pushing Isaac around. They're hooligans from Fallbrook. They sweep into town, drop supplies off behind the warehouse, and spend the rest of their stay getting rowdy over tossball games. They usually loiter in the alley behind the yacht club. They're not allowed in the bar anymore. I bet you anything Isaac ran into trouble with one of them. Mr. Sanjar will be pleased to hear about it when you're done. I know he gets fed up with the Fallbrook bullies, but there's not much he can do.
Velma seem out of sorts to you?
She's always cranky.
No.
What are the chances of all the times and places we could have been born?
Yeah.
We're here, light years from Earth, going about our lives.
Every time the punch clock peals, a worker earns his meals.
What are you talking about?
You're distracted. It's dangerous, Parvati. Spit it out.
I'm still fretting about Jun Lei. About how maybe she might not like me anymore. You had a sweetheart once. Was you... Courtship as uncertain as mine?
Nah, I ain't the type to make things uncertain. I see something I want, I take it, or I die trying.
Who the fuck are you? This ain't your alley.
I don't have time for this. Carry on.
Hey! What are you doing here? This is our secret alley. Berta already pissed by those crates to market. Listen, that purple tooth twerp had it coming. Not that anyone has proof. And not that it's any of your business.
Watch out!
Don't mess with me!
Who the fuck are you? This ain't your...
Hey! What are you doing here? Berta! Listen, and not that it's any of you...
So the ship talks? Do all ships do that?
I can't say for certain, since I only ever been on this one. Ada's something special, though, ain't she?
Ada, what is it? She? It? I'm a bit fuzzy on the details.
Used to be, I thought she was a simulated intelligence. You know, a long series of commands telling her how to react to certain inputs.
You used to? What do you think now?
Well, I worked with a lot of machines, and ain't none of them like her. They can be pretty smart, but mostly they're rule books with a voice box. Ada's different.
One of life's mysteries, I suppose. I don't trust it. If it crashes us into a star, I'll be a mite upset.
Well, I see you've had a sobering effect on our friend Nioka.
Sir, please stop.
Forgive me, Celia. I couldn't help myself. Anyway, what can I do for you? But that's terrible. What happened? But that means we won't be able to log their testimonies. If there's one thing I've been hoping to re-establish in Stellar Bay, it's proper documentation for legal matters. Always a shame when tempers get the better of good sense. Still, your intervention in the matter is much appreciated. Please consider this payment for your services.
Clever.
Worry all that ammo in your berth might combust?
Wait, that's... It can do that?
All it takes is a little bit of black powder next to a lot of bits of fertilizer and one real hot day and... I've seen it happen.
I don't know what's more unsettling. The concept of my ammunition spontaneously combusting or the fact that this is the kind of thing you think about on the regular.
Greetings, and welcome to Monarch Stellar Industries, producers and purveyors of the finest Saltuna and Halcyon. What can I do for you today? You know, sending you is the first bright idea I've seen from that man, because I told him to stop bothering me about it a week ago. I still don't know anything about it, but if you want to help him, Velma's the one to ask. She's in the warehouse. But I'll warn you, Grimm wore her patience thin a long time ago.
Or is he not paying you on account of how he tried to fix the thing his own self and busted it even worse, and then said you wasn't fixing it fast enough, so he's docking your wages again? Not that I got any prior experience with such.
Not at all. Mr. Nandi treats us all right and pays us well. I just spent most of my paycheck on Raptidon acid. Laws, no. Sometimes it's canid teeth, or mantis worm wings. Whatever Sebastian has in stock, really. So I can talk to him, of course. He doesn't get going about much else.
I reckon she's got a little bit of a squish on this fella.
He's sort of the strong, silent type. Unfortunately, my apartment's kind of filling up with his stuff, and some of the neighbors are complaining about the smell. I couldn't! What if he says no? Hey, maybe you could ask him for me. I mean, a no would still be bad, but it won't be quite as embarrassing if you ask. Oh, Mr. Nandi's doing that thing where he breathes through his nose real slowly. I'd better get back to work. He doesn't talk much, but he's got this quiet intensity, you know? Like there's stuff going on inside his head that you have no idea about. Plus, he's got great legs. It's hard to find a man who doesn't skimp on lower body exercises. You think that's what I'm looking for? Sorry.
I don't know what it is, but my gun's been acting funny. Used to be, I had to correct for a bit of leftward drag. Got used to standing just so, and after a while, it put a thorn in my side, something awful. Lately, though, it ain't pulling. I find my stance much improved.
Oh, that's real good to hear. It took me a while to... never mind.
What? Girl, have you been touching my... ...stuff?